episode 63 of 100 Songs. Today we're talking about the band Heart and the song Magic Man off of Dreamboat Annie, which came out in 1975. Probably my favorite Heart song. I think it is my favorite Heart song. I like the older stuff. I like the early era of Heart. Which I didn't really grow to appreciate until a little bit later. I had heard Magic Man on the radio or something when I was a kid. And I was pretty, I dug it then. I was super young. Like, I don't know. Grade school or something. And, I heard it and just thought it was really unique and different, mostly because of the instrumental part in the middle, which we'll talk about a little bit. But it's just a great song overall. And of course, growing up, I heard Barracuda and you know, some of their bigger hits back in the day. Never really thought much of it as a child, I guess, and then fast forward to the 80s, and when Heart really got huge with some of their big songs that came out in the 80s, the self-titled album in 85, Alone. I mean, there's just a bunch of really big songs that got heavy rotation back then. I heard all of that stuff then a lot. That whole era of Heart, I heard a lot. And while I appreciate it, and you know, for what it is, it's a huge pop sort of, is this, their older stuff is more rock oriented. It's got more of a classic rock feel to it, whereas their 80s stuff is more mainstream and pop sounding, but they got huge off of that, big time. And while I appreciate it, I was never like, I think I did actually buy their self-titled album. I did. I think me and everybody else bought that. Millions of people bought that album. It is really good. And it's just not the type of music I would normally listen to. I think I did listen to a little more pop back in the day, but anyway, Heart's still around, and they've had a very long career. Like a lot of bands that have been around a long time, have had some interruptions and some breaks and a hiatus here and there. A lot of lineup changes and stuff like that. But they've got a tour was announced a couple months ago. January of 2024, they announced an upcoming tour. It's like, wow, all these years later, a tour. Like, it's been around almost 50 years, maybe even 50 years. If you go back to the original Heart, then they've been around 50 years. Heart was actually formed by the bass player at the time, Steve Fossen, and brothers Roger and Mike Fisher. They were initially named Army, and then changed their name to White Heart, and then eventually landed on Heart. This is the very early 70s. But when you think of the band Heart, you think of the two here, Ann and Nancy Wilson. They're Heart is mostly about the two of them, daughters of a Marine Corps captain, grew up in Southern California and Taiwan, being military daughters, and then eventually settled into Seattle, Washington. Now, Anne joined the band first. I think she hooked up with Mike Fisher. And then when Nancy joined in 1974, she got into a relationship with Roger Fisher. I think they discovered the band. I think Anne was going to went to a show and saw them performing live under a different name. It was I'm forgetting the name of the band. Hocus Pocus. Was it Hocus Pocus? I think it's Hocus Pocus. And that's how they became introduced. And then there was some romance. And then they formed, added, there were some other members too, obviously, than those. But then that's when the core band formed that would then go off and record Dreamboat Annie in 1975. So they toured around Vancouver and gotten some popularity. And then that's when they recorded this gem right here, Dreamboat Annie. And then the follow-up to that, Little Queen, also very successful. Of course, has the song Barracuda on it. And they were getting big at that point. And that's the sort of the origin, I guess, really sloppy origin story of Heart. The next two albums after this slumped and didn't do as well. But then in 1985, like I said, the Heart self-titled album was huge and sold over 5 million copies, which is a shitload of copies. And that put them on the map again. I feel like they went sort of on the map, so to speak, twice. First with this initial stuff that you would hear on the radio all the time that people really loved. And then again in 1985, it was almost like a different band, but clearly not, because Ann Wilson's vocals are so distinct and remarkably good. That's the constant there. So clearly the same band, totally different style of music though. You know, people have their preferences, I guess. I prefer the more rock-driven early stuff. But like I said, definitely appreciate the poppy stuff too. So, on and on and on. There was a late 90s hiatus to work on another project called The Love Mongers that they, the Wilson sisters, did together. Then they returned in 2004. And well, that's 20 years ago and been doing stuff obviously since, and apparently going to be touring soon. So, they're heavily influenced by Led Zeppelin, which I think is pretty cool. Of course they do that epic version of, the Led Zeppelin song, Stairway to Heaven. Which is great. You should watch it. It's really good. But they do that with Led Zeppelin in the audience watching. And it's a cool video to see for sure. Let's listen to a little bit of Magic Man. This song starts out the first... For a song like this, it's pretty... what would I consider a radio song? It's got some length to it. It's five and a half minutes. First couple minutes are kind of your standard fare. Great, verse, chorus, rhythm, and you kind of get into the flow of the song for the first couple minutes, and you're like, yeah, this is a good song. And then it goes into this instrumental part in the middle, which always stuck out to me. Like I said, when I was a kid, I would hear this part and be like, what is this? This is really cool. And then it kind of goes back into the regular structure of the song. But that whole back two-thirds of the song, or back half of the song, or middle of the song, however you want to say it, is special. And what kind of makes this song stand out, even though it was already a great song. So... let's pick it up at the chorus as it goes into the instrumental break. We're not going to listen to the whole thing. Everybody's heard this, I think. If you haven't, you know, go listen to it. It's great. The link's in the description. It always is. But you've heard it. Come on. Let's just do a sampling here. This has a very 70s sound. I dig it. I love the guitar here too. It goes on, and then you kind of get into that groove, and then this sort of this keyboard just blows into the song, and I like how the keyboard in that part. Maybe I should just play it. It's hard to describe, but on the downside of the keyboard part, it goes into a really low, like. And it sustains, and then it rides a little bit, and then comes back out. I love the sound of that. It's a very low, but it sustains, and then it kind of rises, and then the rest of the song's happening. I like stuff like that. I picked up on that, and it stands out to me now. It's a cool audio moment. Fuck it, we'll just play it. I'll kind of point out when it happens. Maybe think I'm crazy. Another part I like is when they're like, I'll say, here's the keyboard part that's kind of unexpected, and it drops. Like that for some reason, and then the harmony in the back of them going like that with them in the background during that part of the song is what stands out the most to me in my memory as a kid hearing that. I was like, what is this angelic sound that I'm hearing? I like this a lot. It's like, I don't know, 7 or something. Okay, I've gone a little overboard now talking about this song. Let's go to the wheel and see what we've got in store. All right, as we're approaching the 2/3 through this project, 2/3 waypoint, we can see that these pie slices are getting fatter and fatter. So we're getting down to, well, we still have 36 to go. Let's see what's up next. Okay, Not a Surf and the song High Speed Soul. All right. See you next time. Thanks.